The name Baphomet appeared in trial transcripts for the Inquisition of the Knights Templar in 1307. King Philip IV accused the Knights of worshiping the Baphomet and participating in homosexuality. And so the Knights Templar were arrested, and they were tortured, and they were killed. Shortly thereafter, the Baphomet was subsequently incorporated into occult and mystic traditions. The word Baphomet came into popular English usage in the 19th century during debate and speculation on the reasons for the suppression of the Knights Templar. In 1854, the French occultist Alephius Levi published a book called Dogma et Ritual de la. He published two volumes, 1854 and 1886. He described the Baphomet as the Sabbatic goat. The Baphomet of Levi became an important figure within the cosmetology of Thelema, the mystical system that was established by Aleister Crowley. Now, this image of Baphomet that most of us are used to seeing by now was drawn by Levi, so he is the creator of this particular image. Now, Aleister Crowley was a famous black occultic magician. He is known as the most wicked man in the world. He even called himself 666 the Beast. Aleister Crowley wrote several different books, but in his Magic Book 4, Crowley asserted that the Baphomet was a divine androgyny and the hieroglyph of arcane perfection, seeing that which reflects what occurs above, so reflects below, as above, so below. And that's where we get that terminology from. It would be safe for one to say that Aleister Crowley is the main reason why the Baphomet became as big as it is today. We all know that Aleister Crowley's influence is still in the world today, even though he's no longer here. His influence still stands today. I mean, take a look at what Jay-Z's shirt says. Do what thou wilt. That is an occultic statement. And it represents Lucifer. Do what you want. There are no sins. There are no consequences. That's what that represents. There is even an album that came out in 2016 by the rapper Absol that is called What? Do What Thou Wilt. No surprise there, right? Now, getting back to the video at hand, we have Anton LaVey, the guy with the devil horns right here. He's the founder of the Satanic Temple, and he started to use the Baphomet and the goat imagery to represent the Satanic Temple. And he is the founder of the Satanic Temple. As we can clearly see, the goat represents the devil. The goat represents Satan. The goat represents evil. Now, I'm not saying that if you like goats or you have a pet goat that you're evil. It's just that the goat has been used to represent Satanism. And over the years, we have been bombarded with movies and music albums that show some type of goat symbolism with the pentagram. Let's just take a look at a few here right now. Nowadays, there is a term that is thrown around quite loosely, and I'm pretty sure you know what that term is. When someone says, I am the GOAT, or he is the GOAT, a lot of people believe it to mean greatest of all time. But in fact, what it actually means is you're saying that you are the devil. They have programmed us so well into where people are openly calling themselves Satan by saying that I am the GOAT, or he is the GOAT, or she is the GOAT, or however you want to say it. Whether you think it means greatest of all time or whatever, the bottom line is that the GOAT is used heavily in the occult and in Satanism to represent Satan himself. So if you're calling yourself the GOAT and the GOAT is used as a way to represent Satan, you're either calling yourself a Satan or a Satanist. So keep that in mind when you use this term. So the devil wants you to call yourself a GOAT or call yourself a Satanist. He wants you to think that being called a GOAT is a good thing. And I mean, I think he's been pretty successful at that. I mean, we have emojis that represent the devil, the GOAT. No surprise there. Anyway, let's continue. Now that we've got that figured out and out the way, let's get into the symbolism of the Baphomet. We're going to talk about what it represents and what it means. So when we look at the Baphomet, what do we see? We see a winged deity that has female breasts and a phallus sticking up. Now, the Baphomet is also androgynous. Androgynous means having the characteristics of male and female. And when we look at the hands, we see the hands pointing upward and the hands pointing downward. This represents as above, so below. Now the phallus here represents the masculine side of the deity. And now the breast here represent the feminine side of the deity. So what we are essentially looking at is a hermaphroditic deity. It has both characteristics of male and female. And that's where this whole transgender thing comes into play. If a person is wearing clothes, if they're a male and they're wearing women clothes, or vice versa, they are actually representing satanic values and principles. This is why we're seeing such a rise in transgenderism, because of the influence of the devil. And the devil is literally known to have male and female characteristics. And this is exactly why we're seeing transgenderism in the world being promoted so heavily. Now, in pagan religions, they have both male and female gods. The father god and mother god are both Lucifer, a form of Satanism. Cross-dressing is a form of satanic values and principles. So the world is basically doing everything to get the world acquainted and comfortable with Satan. In order for Satan to come as the Antichrist, he needs to have the world ready for him, ready to worship him, ready to be deceived into worshiping the Antichrist. And one way that they're getting the world familiar with the Antichrist is by promoting Satanism and occultic themes through the GOAT. That's what the GOAT represents. And right now, there are a lot of videos on YouTube specifically that have some kind of goat in the video. Let's take a look.
We got a goat, we got a goat.
Has released limited edition goat beer. Of course, goat stands for greatest of all time. Strong, brewed in the honor of a strong team with a goat on the label. Too old, too slow, still here. That's Tom Brady. The back of the can, that's what it reads. 41-year-old will play in his 9th Super Bowl Super Sunday, the most ever for a quarterback.
You gonna try it?
I'm not really into that craft beer stuff. A nice cold lager. That's all I need.
Huh? Okay.
Well, it's an event that's created a lot of buzz among local churches and Christian groups. The largest public satanic ceremony in history happening right here in Detroit. 7X News reporter Jane Park is live with us tonight. Jane, organizers went to great lengths to keep this a private, exclusive party. What's up?
They really did, Dave. Now, we are standing along Grand River, and the building behind me was where guests originally came. But shortly after they were let in, they were told to go to a second undisclosed location where we're to believe that party is going on right now. The Satanic Temple made it very clear it would be their members and their guests and not our cameras that will be getting a first look at this much-talked-about statue. The lines ran along the graffitied walls, at least 100 people eagerly waiting for what's been kept well under wraps.
It said, dress like an animal or wear horns and tails.
Some drove in from as far as upstate New York to see the Satanic Temple unveil a 9-foot-tall bronze statue of a goat-headed Satan.
It just seemed like it would be a historic event.
The guests came dressed to impress. Each paid at least $25 for a ticket. Security inside was tight. No cameras or media. No cell phones and photographs allowed. The secretive nature of the event didn't prevent a few protesters from attending.
We figured, well, if they're going to unveil a statue and show a statue, well, we're going to show the statue that beat this statue behind the scenes in reality. That's, recounted in the St. John's Apocalypse that St. Michael and his angels defeated Lucifer and his angels.
Members of the Satanic Temple, who say they stand for the separation of church and state, kept mum Saturday night, focused instead on showing their guests a good time. Some came out of curiosity, others just to appreciate the art. And they say don't knock it just because it's not your taste.
A sculpture or a piece of art or a tribute to something that they don't understand is not necessarily going to impact their religion or their beliefs.
There was so much buzz about the night, Detroit police set up outside just to make sure the Satanists and the naysayers stayed civil.
You know, we support anyone's First Amendment right to practice whatever religion they want or to come out and protest against that, you know, their freedom of speech. So, you know, we're there basically to protect the rights of everyone involved.
In the end, the group made good on its promise to make this an exclusive event. Guests patient enough to make it through the line were promptly sent out the back door, where outsiders can only imagine the real party awaits. A party, we're told, is supposed to last well beyond midnight. As for the statue, it could end up at the Arkansas State Capitol, where there is a Ten Commandments statue also planned. Live near downtown Detroit, Jane Park, 7 Action News.
Try to find new ways to exercise and stay in shape. A farm in New Hampshire is offering a very different experience, yoga with goats. It's catching on, and the farm owner says they are scrambling to try to keep up with this viral sensation.
If heaven were a place on earth, it might look a little like Jeunesse Farm in Nottingham, New Hampshire, where the welcoming committee consists of a friendly turkey named Cricket, and where goats and yogis coexist in perfect harmony.
Finding some calm.
Yoga with goats is a new offering at the farm.
Hear the patter of little footsteps around us.
And it's certainly a one-of-a-kind experience.
I've done yoga a few times, but it was nothing like this.
If you have a goat on your back, you can stay right in tabletop.
It's gone viral.
Farm owner Peter Corvo says they just started classes a week ago. Now they're booked till June.
You know, who doesn't love baby goats? There's nothing cuter than a baby goat. Just something about them, their nature.
It's a simple idea, really. Goats and people doing yoga together. It's actually hard to tell who's enjoying it more. Instructor Janine Bebo says it's not just the legs and the abs getting a workout.
I left class last week and my face was sore from smiling so much.
These yogis agree.
You can't help but laugh. You can't help it. The laughing and the smiling just comes along with it.
There's so much more to this practice than the downward facing goat. The back massages and the snuggles, they're an added bonus.
I would definitely recommend this, and I can't wait to come back.
I was laughing in the corner. I mean, just to like stay, you know, in your meditation.
Didn't quite have your chance to get the goats jump on you, Jack.
Yeah, no, they definitely had their work cut out for them trying to just continue with the poses. But they've only been doing this for 1 week. They have received so much feedback on this that they're booked until June. They're looking to expand to hopefully try to accommodate more people. So they're trying to expand upstairs. Wow. But I mean, kind of a great idea. People are loving it.
Yeah. Do you see? And I guess what you were seeing is that people, when you go down into those poses, the baby goats naturally want to jump up.
They just jump right up on people, and they just love it. So if you are interested in this, you'll have to head to their website. We have it on our website, how you can get into this. But again, they are booked up till June. So
And they don't stay baby goats for long.
Exactly. All right. So we'll see.
They'll grow up some.
Okay, so this is the visualizer for the song Porno by IDK. Now, I want you to take a really good look at this picture, because this picture is actually biblically significant. On the left side of IDK, we have a lamb, and on the right side of IDK, we have a goat. How is this biblically significant? Let's take a look at what the Word of God says about lambs and goats. Matthew 25:31-33. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And he will see the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. So what this scripture is telling us here is that when Christ returns, he will separate the sheep from the goats. The sheep represent the righteous, and the goats represent the wicked. Now, looking at this visualizer, we can see that IDK has a lamb on the left and the goat on the right. But the scripture tells us that the goat will be on the left and the lamb will be on the right. So this is basically a backwards interpretation of that scripture. So what I gather from this visualizer is that IDK is presenting himself as the Savior. He's presenting himself as Christ. That's why we see him in the visualizer with the sheep and the goat. Now, it's nothing new that many rappers try to portray themselves as messianic figures, just like IDK here. Let me just show you guys a few examples of rappers who try to portray themselves as messianic figures. Let's take a look. So looking at this video here, we can see Lil Wayne being crucified as if he's Christ. See, I have a problem with this because, you know, you can tell me these celebrities don't have a Christ complex where they feel like they're Christ. This right here tells you that these people consider themselves to be the Messiah, the messianic figure. This is nothing new in hip hop. There was even a few people that said that when Nipsey Hussle died, that he was the Messiah. No, Nipsey Hussle was not the Messiah, okay? The Messiah, Jesus Christ, he didn't promote materialism. He didn't promote money. He didn't promote these things that Nipsey Hussle promoted. So no, Nipsey Hussle is not the Messiah. But this is how the devil has influenced folks into thinking that these rappers are messianic figures. And that's just not the case. Let's continue. Now, getting back to IDK. So, what we have learned so far is that IDK is presenting himself as the Messiah, and this is why he has the sheep and the goat. Now, let's take a closer look at IDK. Now, this song Porno was on his album, which is called Is He Real? Which sounds like Israel. So let's connect the dots here. The artist's name is IDK, which stands for I Don't Know. He has an album called Is He Real? So if we put it together, it says, Is he real? I don't know. So as we can clearly see that there is a push to familiarize people with satanic principles, and not only that, but to equate people with worshiping Satan, to normalize worshiping Satan by using the goat as a symbol to mean the greatest of all time. Even in the biblical days, people were worshiping false gods, and those false gods are represented as having horns, just like we're seeing today in the mainstream media pool. Another thing to keep in mind as well is that most of the time during these satanic rituals, goats are actually sacrificed when certain rituals are being performed. So not only is there a sacrifice aspect to this, but also an agenda to familiarize people with worshiping Satan and giving homage to Satan through the goat. So I hope this video has opened up your eyes and helped you to understand how we are being desensitized into accepting Satan and to worshiping Satan. And I really would appreciate it if you guys would share this video far and wide so we can wake the world up to what's going on so that we won't be fooled into worshiping Satan.